A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st November. On the front page you have government questions WhatsApp after spyware is used for snooping. So this is the central government has now sought explanation from WhatsApp. It is an international news which we saw in yesterday that in which WhatsApp has sued NSO Group, an Israeli technology firm, which claims on its website that its products are used exclusively by government agencies and law enforcement agencies to fight crime and terror. So it had accused NSO Group of snooping. So now Indian government has sought explanation from WhatsApp about this issue, that you know, Indian journalists, lawyers, Dalit and human rights activists are targeted. So government has questions like, how does Pegasus come in your phone? Like, this Pegasus is the spyware of NSO Group, an Israeli technology firm. So who were targeted and what does it do, and are individuals, are we safe? So this is tried to be answered here. Then this is NSC and IIM back in talks on Naga peace deal, says Ravi. So Naga interlocutor RN Ravi has said that discussions to finalize the Naga accord were continuing and NSC and IIM had come on board now. So there were rifts, but now they have come on board. Then below you have core sector output falls 5.2% in September. So the overall output of 8 core infrastructure industries have contracted, means it is -5.2% in September 2019. So this indicates the severity of the economic slowdown too. So these are the 8 core sectors which are part of the index of industrial production too. You can see they are mentioned here, like refinery products, cement, steel, electricity, coal, etc. On page 8 you have Cyclone Maha batters Lakshadweep and Kerala. So 759 people have moved to shelters in islands where 100 fishermen have sought refuge to. So Lakshadweep islands and to a relatively lesser extent coastal districts of Kerala have bore the brunt of Cyclone Maha, which continues to cut a furious swath across the Arabian Sea. So you can see a person standing on geotextile bags placed along the coast in Kochi, so to cut the water flow as such. And this is Hyderabad figures in UNESCO list. So it has been selected as creative city in the category of gastronomy. So Hyderabad, the city of biryanis, kebabs, haleem, as such, has been officially designated as the UNESCO Creative City of Gastronomy. So it's among 66 cities named by UNESCO in this list of new creative cities. On page 9 you have sex ratio improves in country, birth and death rates dip. So total fertility rate in 12 states has fallen below 2 children per woman now. So both birth and death rates in India have consistently decreased over the years, but there is wide gap among states as such. So this graph plots the rates from 1991 to 2017 for both birth rate and death rate. Then below you have army to continue to try its personnel for adultery. So moral turpitude has no place here is what the army continues to say. So army will continue to try its personnel for adultery and homosexuality under the provisions of the Army Act. So this is called unbecoming conduct despite Supreme Court decriminalizing both. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Relief for Pehlu's son. So this is regarding yesterday's front page news in which we saw Rajasthan High Court has quashed the cow smuggling case against Pehlu Khan and his sons. Pehlu Khan was lynched to death by cow vigilance in 2017. In the case of lynching, the accused have been left scot-free because of lack of evidence that we had seen earlier in 2019. And this is another election. So this is regarding the elections in December in the UK as such. So Prime Minister Boris Johnson's European Union withdrawal agreement hangs in balance, and general election has been called for December 12. So that is actually an election called in UK to have a mandate on Brexit. So it is said this is an opportunity for Labour to clarify its views on Brexit. So Boris Johnson, the Prime Minister, belongs to Conservative Party. The lead article, Deciphering Greta's Climate Message. So this is Swedish teenager activist who has prominently come to news. So it is said there is more to the Swedish teenager activist's point of view than mere emotion and passionate commitment. So she has been protesting and people have joined her in protests against climate change. And this is Substance Across the Arabian Sea. So this says, amid turbulence in West Asia, India-Saudi Arabia ties have not only remained steady but kept their positive trajectory. So there are many issues going on in West Asia. The Syrian issue, the Iranian issue, Iran-Saudi Arabia conflict, etc. But India and Saudi Arabia, recently we saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi was in Riyadh and we have signed MOUs too. And a strategic partnership council has been established. So this article says that India-Saudi Arabia ties have not only remained steady in rough times but have kept their positive trajectory too. The Kashmir issue was also not prominently raised. Then on Fridays on the OPED page, you have a question on which views, counter views are given. So yeah, this is parlay coverage. So this is, do voters differentiate between state and national polls? So we have seen how in national elections BJP had done quite well, but at state level, presently in Maharashtra and Haryana elections, the results were below than expectations and below than what was seen in the national elections this year itself. So it says Modi factor looms large in national elections, but states are more competitive. And this is cleaning up the Kashmir mess. So it says Nehru can't be blamed for the flawed policies that New Delhi designed for Jammu and Kashmir since the 1990s. On page 12 you have Beijing illegally holds parts of Indian territory. So this has been reminded by India that creation of Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh was entirely an internal affair, and also parts of Jammu and Kashmir which India claims are under Chinese control. So this has been an issue which has been, the Aksai Chin region is under Chinese control, you should know that. So also Pakistan has given a part of its territory to China, so it holds that region. And this is Maharashtra officials deny any role. So it is said phone tapping is carried out through a committee of senior officials. But senior officials of Maharashtra Home Department said the government is not in the know of any activity involving private or government organization snooping on activists and lawyers in the state. On page 13 you have Jadhav case. Pakistan violated its obligations. International Court of Justice tells UN. So judge has elaborated on aspects of the court's ruling of how Pakistan violated its obligations under Vienna Convention in the arrest and detention of Indian national Kulbhushan Jadhav. So this case we have been following for a long time now. ICJ also gave its verdict in favor of India. And now it is reporting this to United Nations. And this is MPs grill officials on DNA bill. So this is the DNA technology use and application regulation bill of 2019. So parliamentary panel headed by Congress leader Jairam Ramesh began hearing on this bill, and it has grilled members as such officials from the Department of Biotechnology on scope for violation of privacy in the proposed DNA data bank. It actually seeks to create a data bank of suspects and missing persons, but then there are loopholes. So how it can violate privacy, right to privacy, is the concern. On page 14 you have at least 74 people killed in Pakistan train inferno. So fire was triggered when two gas cylinders that passengers were using for cooking breakfast exploded. So this is a disaster which has struck Pakistan. And this is regarding rules. So actually US House has finalized rules, has approved rules for the impeachment of President Donald Trump. So this was the first formal test of support for the inquiry, impeachment inquiry against Donald Trump. And this is Islamic State names Baghdadi successor. So the militant group has warned US it will avenge its leader's death. And this is Twitter bans political advertisements. So decision has been taken to curb misinformation, and Democrats have praised it while Trump campaign has disliked it. So Twitter has banned political advertisements. And this is US slams Russia over S-400 deals. USA has been trying to pressure countries, especially India and Turkey, on not buying S-400 from Russia. And now US is, again, military affairs envoy said, Russia is exploiting countries' security requirements. So this is, you can see, India has also decided to buy S-400 for $5.2 billion in 2018. But USA doesn't want India to buy them. It is threatening with sanctions. It has brought up an act in its country that is called CATSA Act, Countering American Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, targeting Russia. Russia as well as other countries like Iran, South Korea, North Korea. On business page you have RBI creates new verticals for supervision and regulation. So new departments with specialized cadres on supervision and regulation within RBI will start functioning from 1st November. So departments with specialized cadres will go live today, that is. So you can see these departments have been created by merging respective supervision and regulation departments on banks, non-banks and cooperative banks. So you see, there's banking supervision, non-banking supervision, cooperative banking supervision will come under one new vertical, that is Department of Supervision. So same will happen for three regulatory departments, other three regulatory departments also as such. So this means vertical specialization is being sought. And below you have Jio rights to center objects to relief sought by Bharti and Vodafone. So Jio, Reliance Jio has said both operators have financial capacity to clear dues. So dues which have been announced by Supreme Court, there should be no relief given to them, is what the Reliance Jio wants. So because it is not affected by the Supreme Court ruling, it's a new entry in telecom sector. And this is paid 97% of GST refunds due to MSMEs. So Finance Ministry has said that 97% of GST refunds due to micro, small and medium enterprises have been paid by the government. That is 10,490 crore payments have been made. This is what the Finance Ministry has announced. So that is it. The last page does not have any news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashar.com, where you can download the current affairs PDF on a daily basis too. And detailed current affairs news is also covered. It's a separate course, the details of which you will find on our website. Thank you.